Good evening. I'm Jay Marty Cope on the music staff here at PCPC. We're delighted that you've chosen to spend time with us here this evening, either here in person with our great crowd this evening, and also those who are joining us online. During this season of COVID, we're always scrambling to find ways to continue to let the song sing. And we're grateful for medical advisors and different ones along the way who have helped us navigate these waters to be able to continue to provide great art. We're also grateful for these artists who grace us on a regular basis. Those of you who are familiar with the PCPC concert series, the performing arts here, will know that you're in for a treat. You've probably been aware or have heard Christopher Adkins and Stephen Nielson play on a regular basis. As part of these COVID protocols, we're obviously distanced, and thank you for distancing. We're asking everybody to keep their mask on during the performance just to make sure we're able to stay safe, and keep that in mind as well as you exit this evening. Christopher Adkins is, of course, the principal cellist for the Dallas Symphony, wonderful solo artist, as well as a fabulous section leader for the orchestra. And great partner with many fabulous conductors that have come through the DSO. Stephen Nielson is, of course, a concert pianist, Steinway artist, and too has had a great solo pianist, piano career, performing career. They've worked together for a number of years, which has produced recording projects and many different concerts and leading in worship. So we're thankful for this long legacy of musicianship that they have shared, and we're always grateful when we can bring it back on to the Performing Arts Series here at PCPC. Just before I introduce them and we begin our program, would you join me for a word of prayer? During this season, Lord, we are reminded of the gifts you've given us, the beauty which surrounds us. We think of the sights we see, the changing seasons in visual art, both put together by human hands or the art you display in creation. We think of the things we smell, all the different senses in which we can celebrate your creation. We especially tonight think of our hearing and our ears and the way you've given us this gift of music, music which fills our soul. It goes beyond words and explanation. It's something that reaches into our very being and feeds it and reveals things about ourselves and about your design and your gifts that other things can't express. We thank you for these two gentlemen who have used these gifts of music that you've given them to sing out in their playing the beautiful notes of creation. So we pray that you bless our time. May we bring you glory. Would you edify us and fill us and send us from here with full hearts. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you join me then in welcoming Christopher Adkins and Stephen Nielson?
you here in the last 11 months. So many of us have been starved for the live musical experience. And thanks to the hospitality and boldness of this church, we are here tonight, as well as many Sunday mornings since last summer. And we are grateful that you have joined us here in person and those of you watching online as well tonight. I want to thank this church, of course, Park City's Presbyterian Church, for its ongoing emphasis and being the purveyor of the arts, music, in many ways, and particularly to J. Marty Cope, Senior Director of Music, for his leadership and vision for what can be done here and, of course, via our online experience, which is going to be permanent for us, I'm sure, at some level. As you can imagine, we were beginning last summer or early fall to cogitate about what we would play, and that was already deep into the pandemic experience and all that entailed and its challenges. And as we began to think about the program, we thought it's okay for us not to ignore the challenges of this era. And we thought then we would choose a program to speak into and play into life and all of its challenges, but in the end, to give us all hope. And so that is what we are seeking to do with the great variety of music that you will hear on the program tonight. Of course, we can sum it up in many ways, but this next piece by Beethoven is based on the wonderful tune of George Frideric Handel in his oratorio, and the chorus sings, "And we say, and we sing, at the end of the day, thine be the glory."
Thank you. May I just second Stephen's welcome to you all. It is so good to be back in a hall with actual bodies playing actual music. It really is a wonderful thing. Spotify is good, but you guys are better. When it comes to struggle, dare I say there is no composer that personifies that sense of constant striving against forces both personal and malign. No composer personifies this struggle as much as Shostakovich. And I'm not going to say anything more. I'm going to let his music speak for itself.
Thank you.
just before their last piece, they're going to take a quick break to catch their breath after that, and we'll do the last piece on the program. Just a couple of quick items. Because of COVID, we're not going to pass an offering plate down your row, but we don't want you to get away that easy. On your way out these doors, there's a drop box there and back here. If you didn't bring any funds with you, that's fine. You can always send in a check to the Performing Arts here at the church. We're grateful for your support, and those of you who have supported in the past to make this great art come to life, we're grateful, so thank you. We've been planning our series a little bit ad hoc as the year goes on, waiting to see how things played out here in the spring with the virus. I will say that we're working on two more programs for the rest of the spring. One would hopefully include our concert, our choir, and a chamber orchestra. We're aiming for something during Holy Week. We're in the final preparations for that. If you keep an eye out at pcpcconcerts.org, also on the regular pcpc.org webpage, you can find out final details of those events. One, hopefully it'll be Holy Week. We're looking for Good Friday with the chancel choir and orchestra, and then hopefully a chamber concert to conclude our series in late April. So we're in final discussions with different folks to make these things happen. Thank you for joining us tonight. I know I can speak on behalf of Chris and Stephen. They're very grateful for your presence and encouragement, and there's nothing that quite replaces this live interaction of us being together in community as we experience this great art. Would you help me welcome them back to the platform for their last piece?
Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much. That was a workout, but a fun one, and we've kind of covered the spectrum tonight, I think, but hopefully enriched you and gave you some wonderful new musical experiences that will affect and embellish your lives henceforth. I failed at the outset to introduce our wonderful longtime friend, Jonathan Smith, who has been so nice all these years, nearly 20, to turn pages. And as many of you know, I consider a page turner the hardest job in the world, mostly because I have known to have looks that could kill when it's not done. But Jonathan's a consummate musician and a dear friend. And so I'm very grateful for his participation here. Well, to bring us back from the wild pampa of Argentina and let you go with some beauty from this century, we'd like to play for you a tune called Gabriel's Oboe. Some of you know that it was written by Ennio Morricone, marvelous, prolific writer of movie scores and many other things through the years. He just died at a ripe old age last summer. But Morricone has received so many adulations and so many compliments. But one of his most successful tunes, we sometimes call it a cash tune, but it's a beautiful tune. It's from a wonderful 1986 British drama about a Jesuit priest who goes to very difficult times in South America. And this tune is from, the movie is called The Mission, as you might imagine, Gabriel's Oboe.